Hello, how you doing? It's Jovan, and welcome back to another video. So today we gotta watch a video of a Mike Ohan being interviewed on how to see who's fake natty and who's the real natty. In other words, takes one to know one. So I don't know at this rate if this video is legit or it's just a comedy skit. So without further ado, let's get to it.
When you see an actor, let's say, right, or a fitness guy, can you tell if he's natural or not just by looking at them?
I mean, most of the time I think I can. There's, I guess, certain traits. The overdevelopment of traps is one of the things that just grows on men when they're on the chemicals. Also skin texture, and how are you in your 40s still breaking out? That's odd.
Yeah, like to tell if they're a fake natty, all you gotta do is to see if they have an overdevelopment of traps, the gyno nips, and then the skin texture is all fucked up. And bro, at this rate, the man is just literally describing himself. Plus, how do you keep a straight face like that, knowing people from all around the world, he's not natty. He knows that. He knows that everyone knows he's not natty, but the face though, still. Like,
I know at 20 you want the title. I know you want that, and that means everything to you, that 20-year-old. But if you can be patient and take 10 years to put on the muscle and take 10 years to just do this process, you'll still get there and you'll be able to keep it.
Keep it, you say? Yeah, you can't keep it if you're still in your mid-20s up until your late-20s. Because if you want bigger muscle, you need to keep improving in your progressive overload, meaning you're still able to lift more than last time. Unfortunately, when you're reaching, let's say, 35 or late-30s, that's where your testosterone goes down, meaning you're lifting less and you're not making as much gains as you used to.
Who's that? Chris Evans, Mr. America. Was he on for the first Mr. America?
I have no idea. I can't tell. I don't know.
You can't tell? Okay. Let's see.
Mr. America? The fuck is Mr. America? It's fucking Captain America, you dog.
I think we're just so stuck into this, that small little world of health and fitness that if they're that good, they're cheating. If they're that good, they're cheating.
Normally, if you ask people like, "Oh, bro, are you on ghee?" It's pretty much like a compliment saying that they actually look really good, but to tell if someone is not natty is pretty much to just see how shredded they are and how big they are and how much and the amount of gains that they made within a year or two. If the gains double within even by 2 years, that's still quite a lot, because your newbie gains stop after the first 7 months or even a year of training. And then if you gotta make more gains again in the next year or next 2 years, it's gotta be way less compared when you were just starting out.
The role, right? He looks muscular or something like that. And then after the movie is done, you see the next movie and it looks completely different.
Did you ever see Ryan Reynolds in Blade?
Right.
You have to see that. If you
haven't
seen
Blade
that,
3, Blade 3.
Blade 3.
Yeah.
There's not a person, not even Brad Pitt in Fight Club, looked that good. His muscles were rounded, insertions. He looked like, seriously, he could win a classic bodybuilding. He looked incredible. And it didn't hurt that he's a stud.
Why are you on about? Because if you want to be on classic physique or even men's physique competition, you gotta be on the gi. You can't be step up there and be all natty. Unfortunately, that is not the case. Look, don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong. The man actually looks good, but unfortunately, still not worthy to beat that guy from Classic Physique. I forgot his name. Vin Diesel? Oh, Ruff Diesel. Ruff Diesel or even Sebum. You want to beat these two, you got to be on the gi.
Imagine this. If I can take somebody like Heath Evans, who played pro football for 10 years, that's trained since he was 12 years old, and change his body in 3 months, you're talking about an elite athlete. And I could still change him in 3 months doing my principles of nutrition and training. I shouldn't be able to, right? He's trained for 30 years. You're not gonna change that much in 12 weeks.
You forgot to tell people that your training principles includes the gear.
What can you take to somebody like Ryan Reynolds, who's never worked out before, never dieted before, and eats one meal a day, and then he does a whole bodybuilding 12-week nutrition plan? he's gonna look freaking different.
Maybe though, maybe because in terms of bodybuilding training, you're not just hitting one body part with one workout. You'll be hitting them with 2, 3, or even 4. But it kind of depends on which body part you're working on. But Ronald, there is a possibility that he will look super good if he does a bodybuilding training.
Do you ever get tired of people questioning if you're natural? And
I never get tired of it. I also don't really hear it.
Yeah, never heard of it. You're still a fake daddy douchebag. That is pretty much it for today's video. So if you do like this video, give me a like and a subscribe down below. And I'll see you next week for more content. Catch you later.